We are going to start our exercise 10 and I have started. I have taken start from question number 3 in which we have to find the complement angle. Remember that complementary angles add up to make 90 degrees. You are given with one angle and you have to find the other angles. As you know that complementary angles add up to make 90 degrees, so you can do this. Let the angle to be x. As you know that if they are complementary angles, then they will add up to make 90 degrees. 18 is being added on the other, so on the other side it will be subtracted. So 90 minus 18, it will give you 72 degrees. So 72 degrees is the complementary angle of 18 degrees. So you can do rest of the parts by following these steps by yourself. Going towards question number 4, in which you are asked to find the supplementary angles for each of the following angles. I hope that you all remember that supplementary angles add up to make 180 degrees. So you are given with one angle and you have to find the other angle. So our first step, I am going to let that angle to be x. If the both angles are supplementary angles, then they will add up to make 180 degrees. As 36 is being added on one side of the equation, so on the other side it will be subtracted. After subtraction, you will 144 degrees, which is the supplementary angle of the 36 degrees. Going towards our next question, that is question number 5. In question number 5, you are given that line AOB is a straight line. So as you all can see, the diagram is given in the question that AOB is a straight line and you have to find the value of the unknown. As you can see, the value of the unknown variable over here is A. We have to find the value of A. So I'm going to start my solution from here. Remember that you have to make the diagrams in your notebook as well. You all can see that A and 33 are adjacent angles because they are lying on a straight line. They are sharing a common vertex and they are also sharing a common sign between them. So these are adjacent angles. By writing this note, adjacent angles add up to 180 degrees. So you can start that A plus 33 will also add up to make 180 degrees. You have to find the value of A. So 33 is being added on one side of equation, so on the other side it will be subtracted. 180 minus 33 degrees gives you 147. So value of the unknown which we were looking for, the A, its value is 147. Next, I'm going to solve the same question number 5, but it's C part. In the C part, again, you are given that the AOB is a straight line and you have to find the value of the unknown. In this question, the unknown is C. So you will again write that adjacent angles add up to 180 degrees. So as you all can see, these three are adjacent angles. So when you will add these three angles, you will get 180 degrees. As 4C and C are like terms, so they will add up to make 5C. 80 is being added on one side of equation, so on the other side it will be subtracted. After subtraction, you will got 100 degrees. As 5 is being multiplied with the unknown, so on the other side it will be divided. After division, you will got value as 20. So unknown value which we are looking for is 20 degrees. Next one I am going to solve is question number 6. In question number 6, you are given that x, y and z are lying on a straight line. If they are lying on a straight line, then it is obvious that they are adjacent, which means they will add up to make 180 degrees. In the A part, what we have to do, if the value of y is 45 degrees and the value of z is 86 degrees, we have to find the value of x. So I am going to solve my A part over here by writing this as x, y and z are lying on a straight line, so they will add up to make 180 degrees. They will be adjacent angles. You are given that the value of y is 45 degrees and the value of z is 86 degrees. So instead of writing y and z, I have placed their value. We are not given with the value of x, so x will remain as it is. Now we are going to add these two. It will be 131 degrees is equal to 180 degrees. We have to find the value of x. 131 is being added on one side of equation, so on the other side it will be subtracted. So your value of x is 47 degrees. Now going towards my B part, in which I am given that x is 2y, z is 3y, we have to find the value of y. Again, I will start my question by writing that x, y and z are lying on straight line, so they will be adjacent and they will add up and make 180 degrees. We are given that value of x, y is 2y, y will remain as, and the value of z is 3y is equal to 180 degrees. As you all can see, these three are like terms, so 2y plus y will be 3y, 3y and 3y will be 6y is equal to 180 degrees. 6 is being multiplied with the variable on the other side, it will be divided. After division you will got the value of y to be 30 degrees. Next, I'm going to start my question number 7. In question number 7, you are given that for each of the following figures, you have to find the value of the unknown. You will be given with some figures in the question. I'm going to solve my C part over here. I have drawn the picture of the C part. In the C part, you can see that there are 16C, 4C, 4C, and there was only one block shown in the book. Remember that this block shows you the angle of 90 degrees. You can start your solution by writing the point. So angles at one point add up to make 360 degrees. They complete one complete circle, so they all will add up to make 360 degrees. Sum of angles at one point add up to 360 degrees. So when you add these three, these all angles, I'm going to start from 16C. 16C plus 4C plus 90 plus 4C, your sum will be equal to 360 degrees. 16C, 4C and this 4C, these three are like terms, so I'm going to add them. 16C and 4C will be 20C. 20C and 4C will be 24C. 90 is being added on one side of equation, so on the other side it will be subtracted. 360 minus 90 degree. 24C is equal to 270 degrees. 24 is being multiplied over here, so on the other side it will be divided. After division, you will got your angle to be 11.25. I am not going to do the division over here. You have to do it by yourself. I am going to just write your answer. So your unknown, which was C, its value is 11.25 degrees. Question number 7, D part. The figure of the D part is over here. We have to find the value of D, as D is the unknown over here. I am going to start my solution by writing this point. Sum of angles at one point is 360 degrees. So when you will add all these angles, 7D plus 23 plus 5D plus 139 plus 6D is equal to 360 degrees. 7D, 5D and 6D, these three are like terms. So when you will add these three terms, you will get 18D. 23 and 39, these both are like terms, so when you will add 23 and 139, you will get 162 is equal to 360 degrees. We have to find the value of D. 162 is being added on this side of equation. When you will take 162 on other side, it will be subtracted from 360. When you will subtract, you will get 198 degrees. 18 is being multiplied with the variable, so on the other side it will be divided, and when you will do the division, you will get the value of D to be 11 degrees. In question number 8, you are given with a figure and you are given data is, and your given data is the figure AOB and COD are straight lines. AOB and COD are straight lines. AOE is 90 degrees, so AOE, this block is representing 90 degrees. BOD is 48, this angle is 48. What we have to find in the first part is AOC, we have to find this angle, AOC. So I'm going to solve my first part. To find the value of AOC, first I need to find the angle BOC, which I can find out by the help of this 48 degrees. As you know that COD is a straight line, so 48 and COB, they both angle will add up to make 180 degrees. So I'm going to name this angle as X. So as COD is a straight line, hence 48 degrees plus x will equal to 180 degrees. 48 is being added, so on the other side it will be subtracted. So your value of x is 132. Using the value of x, I can find the value of AOC. So you will write as AOB is a straight line, hence line, so angle AOC plus X will equal to 180 degrees. We don't have the value of angle AOC, but the value of X which we have found out as 132 equal to 180. 132 is being added on one side, so on the other side it will be subtracted. You will get the value of AOC to be 48 degrees. In the second part, you have to find the angle DOE. You have to find this angle. For this purpose, I am going to use my this line, as AOB is a straight line, so all these angles will add up to make 180 degrees. As is a straight line, hence 90 plus DOE plus 48 degrees will be equal to 180 degrees. 90 and 48 are like terms, so we have to add them. 138 degrees is equal to 132 degrees. 138 is being added on one side of equation, so on the other side it will be subtracted. So your DOE is 42.